17 years you've been in the league. 17 years, no championship. Right now, what's going on in your heart and in your head?
I just can't believe the journey. You know, the journey, the character of my teammates telling me they want to give me a championship, and tonight they came out and played well. I came here twice, this being my third time, so the third time was a lucky charm.
I don't know if many people from the younger generation knows about Mr. Kidd, but Jason Kidd was like the point god of his era, and I will get more in depth about his incredible career in this video. So pause this, get something cold to drink, and stay tuned, Jake.
I wanna go far, there's no stopping. I see them watching, I see them waiting. One day I swear I'ma be on the station. Mama, I gotta make moves.
Now, if you're really young and you really just started getting into the NBA, you might see Jason Kidd as that funny looking Bucks coach. But if you've been around the block just a tad bit, or you just know the history of the NBA, you will recognize that Jason Kidd is arguably the best point guard of this generation. Jason Kidd, to me, isn't really talked about enough. I mean, the man basically did it all, and the numbers prove it. He's a 10-time NBA All-Star. He's been on 6 All-NBA teams. He's been on 9 All-NBA defensive teams. And the icing on the cake, he's an NBA champion. This year, we heard a special draft prospect compared to Mr. Kidd a lot. And yeah, I'm talking about Lonzo Ball. People compared Lonzo Ball to Jason Kidd simply because both of them looked like they were able to do everything on the basketball court. Both Lonzo and Kidd used an extremely high basketball IQ to see the entire floor and make the smartest basketball decision possible. And you still better respect them because they both can kill you from deep. Also, Lonzo and Jason has a significant size advantage for their position at least, so they're able to snag rebounds almost like a forward. And if you look at Lonzo Ball's career college stats and compare them to Jason Kidd's, they're almost damn near identical. And I'm not exaggerating when I said Jason Kidd could do everything. If there wasn't a GOAT by the name of John Stockton, and by the way, I just made a video about John Stockton, go check it out if you didn't already. But yeah, if it wasn't for John Stockton's career, Jason Kidd would be the all-time steals and assist leader. And like I said, he was a sniper from deep. He's top 10 in three-pointers made for his career. Jason Kidd even holds the NBA career rebound record for guards with 8,000, and he did it as a point guard. And in his prime years before Vince Carter joined the New Jersey Nets, Jason Kidd carried a Nets team to the NBA Finals twice. Now, of course, they got beat down twice by two superior teams, but that Nets team had no business getting that close to an NBA championship. This was the brilliance of Jason Kidd being able to elevate his teammates to the next level. And the year of 2002, Tim Duncan won his first NBA MVP, but there was a lot of NBA fans and media members that believe it should have went to Jason Kidd. That season, Jason Kidd took his team to the NBA Finals, and he averaged close to a triple-double, so they have a pretty good argument. But the crazy part about that MVP race, these two almost became teammates a couple of years later. In 2003, after two straight finals defeats, Jason Kidd became an unrestricted free agent, and there were speculations that he could join the Spurs and replace Tony Parker as their starting point guard. Tony Parker at the time was young and unproven, and he was perceived to have many limitations in his game that Jason Kidd didn't. What a crazy what-if story that would be, right? Imagine how different the history books would look if Jason Kidd was on that team. It could have made him worse, it could have made him better, we would never know. And if you still don't get the brilliance of Jason Kidd, look at the crazy improvement to Bucks star Giannis Antetokounmpo. This season, he was the first player in NBA history to finish in the top 20 in all major stat categories. Jason Kidd once had a season where he was the only player to be top 50 in 10 different stat categories. So you don't see the resemblance? And the Greek freak pretty much turned into damn near a walking triple-double. And Jason Kidd also was damn near a walking triple-double. In the history of the NBA, there's only been 3 players with 100 or more triple-doubles in their careers, and that's been Oscar Robertson, Magic Johnson, and Jason Kidd. Now, at the incredible rate that Russell Westbrook's growing at, he's probably going to be on that list next year too, but you see my point. But you have to keep in mind, when Jason Kidd was doing this, this is when triple doubles were like a big thing. Nowadays, we're almost numb to the stat of a triple double because we just saw two players combine for like 60 triple doubles. Back when Jason Kidd played, there were like 30 to 40 triple doubles in a season total, and Jason Kidd would total for like 10 of them. It feels like back in Jason Kidd's playing days, triple doubles were a little bit more special. But to be honest, I'll understand if guys around my era knows little to none about Jason Kidd. Even his own star player Giannis once questioned his legacy. Giannis said the first time Jason Kidd benched him, he was like, let me see what this guy did in his career anyway. He saw Rookie of the Year, NBA Championship, USA Gold Medal, second in assists, fifth in threes, blah blah. He basically saw Jason Kidd was the truth. That basically just tells me that many fans only remember the old washed up Jason Kidd. But even the old Jason Kidd was pretty deadly. When the Mavericks won the NBA championship, Jason played 37 minutes per game in the finals, and he averaged like an old man's triple-double at 38 years old. Now, I'm not saying Jason Kidd was specifically the best point guard of the 2000s or anything like that, because it's very debatable with him, Steve Nash, Chauncey, I mean, it's very debatable. But this dude was definitely one of the greatest point guards of all time, and definitely a top two, top three of the 2000s, and a lot of people might not know about him, so had to give him his respect. But that's the video, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope I enlightened some of you guys about Jason Kidd's career. I'm not even gonna lie, I didn't even know he was top 50 in 10 stat categories in the season. That's pretty insane, man. This dude was a beast, and I wanted to bring some light into his name. If you guys enjoyed this video, make sure you guys leave a big like. I know I've been gone for like a whole week and some change. School's kind of been hectic. It's even going to get even more hectic in the summer, but I'm going to still push out these videos. Thank you guys so much for 40,000 subscribers, man. 40,000 subscribers, man. That means so much to me, man. I appreciate every single one of you guys that hit that subscribe button. It means so much to me. You guys don't even understand how much it means to me. We had such a great month last month, and we're going to make this one even better. But if you guys enjoyed this video, make sure you guys leave a like, follow all my social medias, do all of that great stuff, guys. And until next time, guys, stay. Lost my voice. Tom J.
Boy, I think they like me. Yeah, they like me. Diamonds on me, ice cream. Oh, that's lightly. My Draco bitch is spitely. Diamonds on me, bite. I heard these niggas wanna fight me. Meet me at my next show, but you better bring a pipe, B. We ain't fight. I think she like me, excited. So excited. Fuck me. Bentley cool, I'm rolling.